Ah, there you all are. Welcome everybody to the 2020 Harrow Way End of Year Assembly. It's time to play the music. It's time to light the lights.
It's time to meet the teachers on the Harrow Way tonight.
Hello everyone and welcome to the Harrow Way End of Year Assembly. Very different this year, here I am in the auditorium in school. Normally, of course, we would be here in the sports hall.
Or possibly, I guess, here.
But this year, we're here conducting the Harrow Way Assembly remotely. I'm here in school, pretty much all on my own. There's no one else really here at the moment. And oh, 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters,
right, Mr. Reed. I just wanted to say...
You're blocking the shot.
What are you doing?
Back, like 2 meters.
Is this the end of your assembly?
Yeah.
I love the end of your assembly. Can we do another song? We could do a song.
We've just done a song. We've just done that whole... By the way, that was based on The Muppet Show, which was a television program in the 1970s, but it looks a bit like a Zoom video. Ask your parents. Yeah, we've just done a song. You were just in the song. You were there. I saw you.
Oh, yeah. Can we do another song?
No, we can't do another song.
Well, what can I do then?
We've got other things we need to do. Like, I may need some help with stuff in a minute. If you could just go and wait over there. But, like, keep 2 metres apart. I'm really sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Reed, he's very excited about being back in school.
Are you sure we can't do a song? We can do a song.
Get back out of shot. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my absolute pleasure to hand over to the face that runs the place. Here's our introduction from Mr. Serich.
Right, morning everyone, and welcome to our final end of year assembly. And what we'd normally be doing now, and looking out my window on this beautiful day, is all gathering as a school community, that's all year groups and all the staff to celebrate the year that has just gone. And year sevens won't have seen this, so there's a few images on screen which will give you an idea of what that special assembly is like. But year 8 to 10 will remember that from previous years. And that's a time where we celebrate all those achievements. And in particular, we present the various trophies and the house trophies for sports day and for attendance and for our very final trophy to decide on who is this year's overall House Cup winners. So we're going to miss that, and what we hope is doing it virtually will give you a little idea and a chance also for us to celebrate what has been an incredible year. So it's now 116 days since the school closed its doors. And although we've had throughout that time, school has been open with about 30 plus students and most recently our year 10s, it's been a little bit like an empty shell without you. Also, the last few months have coincided with the greatest crisis that our country has faced since the Second World War. And it's been a year like no other. And I want to congratulate all of you for doing your very best during these difficult times. We weren't prepared for this, but you really stepped up. Your education has been disrupted and your lives have been disrupted as well. And we know in years to come, when people ask you, what was it like to live in lockdown? I'm sure you're going to have many stories to tell. So the really exciting news is we know that our school community is going to come back together in September, and there is still guidance that we need to follow, but your teachers and I are all really looking forward to welcoming you all back, which we hope is going to be a fantastic year. We'll be sending out more details at the start of term about how the arrangements will work. But I'm sure you also are looking forward to seeing your friends and also getting part back into school life and school routines. And while as the country is now starting to rebuild itself, we're also going to rebuild ourselves as a school community. And you are amazing, bright, talented people, and you're going to be a big part of doing that with us, and I'm sure you're going to rise to the challenge. I also think that during lockdown, there's going to be skills that you've developed. We've all had to become more resilient. We've had to show empathy to others. There's had to be some self-discipline, because working remotely does take self-discipline, and you've got to be well organised and really commit yourself to working with that. And we've had to be patient. There's certain things that we've not been able to do, and you've not seen your friends, certainly in the first part of lockdown, for weeks and weeks. But what we've had to do is support each other. And what I hope is when we return, you know, you're going to carry on being a good friend and a good team member, but also you're going to be kind to all those people around you. And what we want to do is when you come back is bring all those qualities that you developed back into making sure that next year is really successful for you. So this year has not ended the way we would have liked it to, but we're all looking forward to you coming back and bringing back everyone to our Harrow Way family and our Harrow Way community. I hope you really enjoy the virtual end of year assembly. I want to say have a brilliant summer, and we'll see you all hopefully very soon. Bye.
Thank you, Mr. Surrey.
It's a world of laughter, a world of tears.
Embarrassing, sorry. Hello?
Hello. Yeah, Mr. Furlan, what do you think?
Yeah, it's a little bit awkward at the moment. I am in the end of year assembly, which now I think about it is where you're supposed to be. Where are you? Have you remembered?
No, of course I've forgotten. I've left.
Okay. Have you, by any chance, heard from Mr. Manson?
Mr. Manson? No, I haven't heard from him since before lockdown. I don't know if Miss Hamilton has either, actually. Yeah, no, he wasn't in our meeting the other day.
Well, that's really strange if you haven't heard from him either. Okay, I think we'll have a look from him. We'll have a look for him in school. You just get into school. Okay?
Okay, yeah, no, I won't be late. I'm in my car now. I'll speak to you in a bit. All right, bye.
Sorry about that. Just give me a moment. Bear with me. Mr. Reed!
Oh, brilliant. Are we going to do a song?
No. We've gone through this. We're not going to do a song. But what I need you to do, I've got a special job for you. You know how you love special jobs. What I need you to do is I need you to search the school and see if you can find Mr. Manson. Can you do that?
See if I can find Mr. Man. Got it.
Mr. Manson.
Got it. Where is Mr. Manson?
No, Mr. Manson. He's Mr. Man's son.
The son of Mr. Man.
The son of Mr. Man. Go find Mr. Yeah. Manson.
All right, go.
Go. Here are some messages from the heads of year.
Oh, hi there. Some of you know me. I'm Mr. Reed. I'm obviously the head of year seven and the most sophisticated and not in any way silly of all of the heads of year. So, and lockdown is tough. Some of you have been absolutely smashing it though. I know that for lots of you, you've been making the most of the extra time. We'll go through some of your achievements in a second. But even if it's something as simple as helping out the family more, spending more time with those people that you love, learning a new skill, making banana bread, just for getting through this weird end of a year, well done everybody, particularly my year sevens, obviously I'm particularly attached to. So, let's have a little celebrate some of the brilliant things you guys have been up to. Here's some of the achievements of year seven this year.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
And obviously I'm a maths teacher, particularly close to my heart is the maths challenge. Now, we had some Year 7s, did fantastic this year. We're always impressed by anyone that gets a certificate, so bronze certificate, silver certificate. But this year, for only the second time since I've been at Harrow Way, we had a student not only get the best in the school in Year 7, but also achieve a coveted gold certificate. So here's Mrs. Marsh to talk a little bit about that.
I wanted to let you know about the results of the UK Junior Maths Challenge, which this year took place in July, with students from 7X1, 7Y1, 8X1 and 8Y1 taking part and doing so online, which was a first. We had fantastic results, so well done to everybody who took part and the number of people who got bronze, silver and one gold certificate. So Cara Randall in Year 7 got a gold certificate and was best in school. Given that only 6.7% of all entrants to the UK Maths Challenge get a gold certificate, she's done extremely well and we're very proud of her. Bye.
A huge well done there to Cara and everyone that took part in the Maths Challenge. To all of you, to Year 7 and the wider school, well done. This is the end of the year. We know now you'll be back in September and we look forward to seeing you then. You've got through this. However you've got through this, you've done it really, really well. We are super proud of you. Take care and have a lovely summer.
I hope everyone's okay and we'll catch up soon. Bye then.
Keep smiling. Bye.
Hi, I hope you all have a really good summer and I look forward to seeing you all in September.
I hope you're well. Take care and I'll see you soon.
You all have a lovely summer. Make sure you're staying safe and I will see you all in September. Bye.
Have a lovely summer.
Have a lovely summer, everybody.
Have a lovely summer.
Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Hi, mate. Can't believe it's the end of the year already. 2 metres away from me and she now looks like she's the same height as me. It's great. Anyway, just thought we'd say, you know, can't wait to see you in September. Hope you've been really well, hope you've kept safe. And while it's been a little bit of a strange couple of months, lockdown's not all been bad. We've got to spend some time at home. So here's our best bits.
Hello, Year 8.
Okay, thanks for coming to the meeting, guys. Not quite sure where Ed is.
Think he must still be making a guitar or something.
Right, now Ed's here, we can actually start planning properly.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
To go to sleep when I got you next to me. All night, I'm riding with you. I know you got my back and you know I got you. So come up, come up, come up, come up. Let's get physical. Lights out, follow the noise. Baby, keep on dancing like you ain't got a choice. So come up, come up, come up.
You can't taste it, it's not my till volume.
Bye, Year 8. Remember, keep safe.
I really need
need you. I really need your love right now. I'm fading fast, not gonna last. I'm really stupid. I'm burning up, I'm going down. I'm in it bad, don't even ask. When I find myself in the middle, in the middle, in the middle, could you love me more, just a little, just a little? Overcomplicate, but it's simple, but it's simple, but it's simple. Will you love me more, just a little? So tell me now, when every star falls from the sky and every last star in the world breaks, oh, hold me now, when every ship is going down, I don't feel nothing when I hear you say, it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. I'm really sorry. Sorry I dragged you into this. I overthink. That's all it is. The way you love me. The way you love me till the end. The way you love me. Oh yeah, it makes me king again. When I find myself in the middle. When every star falls from the sky and every last star in the world breaks, oh, hold me now. When every ship is going down, I don't feel nothing when I hear you say, it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Hiya, 10. I bet you can't guess what I'm going to be doing most of the summer holiday. I hope you have a wonderful time and a well-earned rest. Be good, and if you can't be good, be careful.
Hiya 10, welcome to Mrs. Brown's sunny weather forecast live from Salisbury. As you can see, it's a bit cloudy, but I'm wearing my sun hat, I've got my shades, I'm all about the summer. So just a quick message to say well done, you've worked really, really hard during lockdown. Have an awesome summer holiday, enjoy the next 6 weeks, and we're very much looking forward to seeing you back at school in September. Take care, bye bye.
Hiya 10, well done for all your hard work this term. Have a lovely summer holiday, get lots of rest, and I'll see you next year.
Bye! Hiya 10, hope you're okay. I just want to say have a fantastic summer. Enjoy the sunshine, stick to the government guidelines, and I'll see you in September. Bye!
Bye 10s, have a great summer and I will see you in September.
Hang on, wait a second. Have a great summer, everyone. Well done for all the remote work. You've done brilliantly. And have a break. You know, have a break from the screens for 6 weeks. No screens at all for 6 weeks.
Happy summer holidays, Year 10.
See ya.
Ma'am, have you seen Mr. Manson?
Mr. Reed,
can't
you say
hello? Oh, I'm so sorry.
Got nothing to do, Mr. Reed?
Oh, Have you seen Mr. Manson? Mr. Man. Hello?
Yes, I'm still running.
Okay.
You broke the bonds and you lose the chains. What a steal I'm found. What I'm looking for. What a steal I'm found. What I'm looking for.
Oh, Marie, there you are. Right, any sign of Mr. Manson?
I literally can't find him anywhere. I'm heading to the sports hall now.
2 meters!
You can come and help me.
I'll come with you. Run the message from the senior prefects.
Okay, 2 + 2 = I want to say 5. Let's check. 2 + 2 = 4. Close enough. I think that's enough maths for me today. Lauren, Rachel got off the plane. She got off the plane. Can you believe it? Hand me the tissues because it's getting too emotional.
Oh my God, that is unbelievable. I'm on my way to yours now.
Loz, it's 2 p.m. Do you think we should do some schoolwork?
Schoolwork? No way. We'll do that tomorrow. Don't tell Mr. Whitworth though.
Great idea. Let's rewatch Friends. I'm never getting over that ending.
No one told you that was gonna be this way. Your job's a joke.
Amazing teachers.
We would just like to say,
from the bottom of our hearts,
that we're all so thankful for
all the support, guidance and encouragement
you have provided us with this year.
We know it can't be easy,
but we really appreciate it.
Everything you have done,
the range of lessons you've provided,
have helped make sure we don't get behind.
Though as much as we love seeing you on screen,
we can't wait to see you in September.
Have a well-earned break.
And just a special thank you to Mr. Serridge.
Thank you for always thinking about our safety.
And our learning.
But please, please take a break.
Manson? We're looking for him. We're trying to find him.
Oh, I haven't seen Mr. Manson anywhere. But are you guys filming for the last assembly?
Yeah, yeah, we're at the moment, actually. That's why we're out looking for Mr. Manson, because the other year heads, they're all giving a little announcement to their year groups at the moment, yeah, so...
Did you want me to do something for year 11?
Does he not know?
Mr. Cole had gone. Year 11 had left.
Yeah, but they're coming back, right?
No. Oh.
You've got your print sticks. You can measure your print sticks.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll leave you to your print stick.
We've got to find Mr. Manson.
Okay. Well, you'll be fine.
Right, well that's it. I've checked everywhere. And well, I've got to get back to the assembly. There's a whole assembly to do.
Where else can you be? We've looked in DT, we've looked in maths, we've gone all the way up to the top of humanities. Where can he be?
Mr. Manson must still be somewhere in this... Did we check the drama room?
Oh...
Drama room.
He's not even in here. Also, when did you change your trousers?
There's no time to discuss that now. We've got no time for continuity. We need to find Mr. Manson.
Hang on, these are his shoes.
Oh, you won't.
Don't you dare close your eyes. God, that's Mr. Manson.
Let me out, please. Please let me out. Oh, thank goodness you found me. I've been trapped in there with Miss McLaughlin since the start of lockdown. I've been trapped in there by myself since the start of lockdown.
There's no time to talk about that now. It's time for the head of house part at the end of year assembly.
Let's do it.
And it's this way. Thank goodness.
Can we please do a song now?
We haven't got time to do a song now. It's time for the heads of houses. And put some shoes on!
Who do you think's actually going to win the House Cup this year, Miss Fowler? I think we're pretty safe in saying Buzzards are going to get it. Well, last year everyone thought that, but Hawks won, if you remember. What about Kesher, though? Actually, have you seen Mr. Manson?
No.
Sorry, I'm late. Sorry, there was this whole thing. There was a cupboard and I didn't have a key. And it's been a really lonely lockdown. What are we talking about?
Are we just how you're going to lose the House Cup?
I think you'll find Kestrels are winners, especially when we have Sports Day, which we...
Didn't happen.
It's over with. It doesn't matter. It's still been a really, really busy year. We've done loads of stuff. Yeah, I can't even remember half the stuff we've done, which is why I made a list. Here's my list of everything that we've done at school this year. Try and keep up. There's been quite a lot. But it started with Roald Dahl Day.
Year 9 visits Southampton Art Gallery.
And Over Trees United.
MFL Bake Off.
Year 10 photography visit to Lyme Regis.
Year 9 and 10 drama visit to the Globe.
Year 9 visits to the DT Design Museum.
Amsterdam Brick Wars.
Blandford Camp Cyber Challenge.
Year 8 visits to the Harry Potter Studio. Hold on, wait.
House school!
Basketball competition. Yes, that's us! That was us! Can anyone remember what happened?
Actually, as I've smashed this one, I might have kept a slide or two.
Well, I guess we need to move on.
Yeah, well, maybe it picked up. Maybe we got better later, eh? Right.
We can stay here if you want.
Okay, so we had the house basketball competition. Then the year 9 and 10 trip to Berlin.
Year 8 and 9 Barcelona football tour.
House Christmas card competition!
Ah, losers. At least we didn't do it as badly as Hawks.
Could you imagine?
He looks quite upset. Let's move on. Then we had the bake-off.
I didn't mean to send that emoji. It was a
steak.
And your boyfriend is a lame. He a square, he a square, he a shape. I do not work at a bakery, but I do want cake. I do not do no makeup.
Right, moving on. Year 9-11 dance show.
Year 9 trips to good food show.
Christmas fair. Charity was the winner. Oh, year 9-11 Shakespeare show.
It's a concert.
Merry Media House Quiz.
Drama Club show.
Year 9 visits Warwick Castle.
NSPCC Numbers Day.
Oh, year 9 and 10 Oxford Science Live.
House Penalty Shootout.
Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
Can I kick it? Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
Year 9 trip to Paris.
Year 8 visit to Cadbury's World.
World Book Day Choose the Group Door Competition. It ended.
What could have happened?
Why are there no more events?
Lockdown.
Today I don't feel like doing anything. I just wanna lay in my bed.
Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, Mr. Serge might be watching.
Well, we did actually do work.
We did.
Do that then.
Yeah. And then we had the lockdown survival guide.
Actually, how did you survive being in a cupboard?
I did some things I'm not proud of, all right? Can we move on?
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it.
Huge shout out as well to Miss Campbell for organising those science riddles. Absolutely fantastic work, ma'am. Cheers.
Also a shout out to Mr. Nias for doing the music quiz. I know everyone had a great time doing that.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to introduce the heads of house! Who, as you can see, are all very excited about the big reveal of the winner of the Attendance Cup and the overall House Cup for this year.
I guess there's not going to be a sports day cup, though.
So I suppose that means it stays with the Kestrels? It's got our ribbons on.
Well, I was thinking about that. I wondered, I mean, it wouldn't be official, but as we've got a bit of time to kill here in the Assembly, I wondered if you would like to take part in a little competition, sort of to unofficially see who might win the Sports Day trophy.
Bring it on.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for your first challenge?
Yes.
Okay, you will notice in front of you are some of my lunchboxes. Inside your lunchbox is a reel of sellotape. The winner of this challenge will be the first person to open their lunchbox, take out the sellotape, get all the sellotape off the reel of sellotape, and put it back inside your lunchbox. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go! Ow! It's a very good start for Miss Fowler. All of the sellotape was sanitised before the start of this task. No sellotape was harmed during the filming of this sequence.
Hold on, do we have to get the sellotape back in the box as well? Oh, man! And the reel!
It's done!
The winner of the challenge, Kestrel!
Yes!
I will say hello. Can somebody help me?
Yeah, that was awesome. That was really good fun. And then, of course, we ended on the 26th challenge.
Heads of House, Boss Buzzard, and... Ooh, can't think of the other two. Ah, they seem irrelevant anyway.
Who's that? What's that? I don't know what I'm doing, but I text her, what's that? What's that? Telling her to come through and then I copped a Big Mac. Milkshake or some large fries, it cost £4.50. Take the gherkin out of the inside. Who's that? What's that? What's that? I don't know what
I'm off to go again. Yay.
Who's that? What's that? What's that? I don't know what I'm doing, but I text her WhatsApp. Telling her to come through and then I cooked a Big Mac. Milkshake or some large fries, it cost £4.50. Take the gherkin out of the inside. House party on a cold night.
And it went like...
I think I'm losing my mind. Where's my wallet? Wallet? Swear it was in my pocket. My bank card was in there and I need to make a deposit. I think I'm about to vomit. I shouldn't have ate that omelette. Bought 50p of Bitcoin, made £2 of profit. My mate says he's lost it. I thought he meant my wallet. What? Can't find his phone, so he asked me to call it. Who's that? What's that? What's that? I don't know what I'm doing, but I text her WhatsApp. WhatsApp. Telling her to come through and then I copped a Big Mac. Milkshake or some large fries, it cost £4.50. Take the gherkin out of the inside. No gherkin. Who's that? What's that? What's that? I don't know what...
And we're going to take a circular walk today.
This girl knows nothing. She can't tell if I'm bluffing. She can't have a good discussion without her trying to push my buttons. And she's not that good with numbers. She stole half my jumpers. Took her to meet my family and she squared up to my cousin. Yeah, she's mad. She tried to fight my dad. Got her a taxi from the airport. She tried to bump the cab and she stole my cat. She burnt down my flat. She went to the club and put her drinks on my tab. Now I'm vexed, I'm broke, but I'm not your average bloke. Went in her purse and placed a kilo of. Then I said good night. Dialed 999. Police locked her up, gave her intent to supply. Bye. 2 hours late for school, but you can't blame me. Fried egg sandwich, white bread, bottle of HP. Ask my cousin when you grow up, what do you wanna be?
What'd he say?
He said a dealer, cause he hates the police.
Okay.
On his birthday, he went from 11 to 13.
Why?
Because 12, he controls the streets. Who's that? What's that? I don't know what I'm doing, but I text her WhatsApp. Telling her to come through and then I copped a Big Mac. Milkshake or some large fries, it cost £4.50. Take the gherkin out of the inside.
No gherkin.
Who's that? What's that? I don't know what I'm doing, but I text her WhatsApp. Telling her to come through and then I copped a Big Mac. Milkshake or some large fries, it cost £4.50. Take the gherkin out of the inside.
76 challenge was brilliant. Right, on the go. Well done, Kestrels. Smashing it. Fingers crossed for the House Cup. See you later.
Yes, Buzzard, well done this year. Absolutely smashed it. Like Liverpool, we've got a few points in hand, so fingers crossed that House Cup is ours. Bye, loser.
Hawks, I am fed up with this. This happens to us all the time. They didn't even celebrate half of our successes. We had the brilliant bird competition, which you all absolutely smashed. We had the MFL, Super Skull and Spirit Guide competition, which you were brilliant in. And let's face it, when it comes to turning up, who's there every day? It's us, because we have the best attendance. Hawks, don't worry. I love you. Next year is our year, and we've got this. Bye!
Mr. Fulham's not here, and that means I can sing my song. And even if he was here, he couldn't stop me, because it's a 2 meter rule. I have run. Ah! Here's Harrow Way Band Jam.
Forgot, we need to pick our lockdown legend. You know, like that one student from the whole school who's just been amazing throughout lockdown, like handed in all their work, learned to speak Dutch and just generally like whittled a shoe out of marshmallow. Any ideas? We need one.
Yeah, one, that's easy. Buzzards have been awesome. I've got Ethan and Beau, both in 7 SNE. I've got Demetrius in 9 SF. I've got Georgia in 9KLK. I've got Christina in 11LW. I've got Tia in 10CAB. I've got loads. There's so many here, guys.
I have lots of hogs as well. I've got Madison Spry in 8HMH. I've got Bridget in 10ECM. I've got Polar also in 8HMH. And I've got Jess in 9DSR. I'm sure there's many more on my emails as well. So how are we going to pick?
Well, no, it'll be easy. We'll just get a Kestrel, because, like, I've had loads of people nominate, like, Luana in 8EJN, Charlie and Megan from 9CSC, and in 8JPM as well, Lily, Hillary, and Lydon. We've just got loads and loads of Kestrels, so we'll just pick a Kestrel.
Oh.
Well, yeah, a Kestrel. It's got to be a Kestrel.
Oh, no deal.
No, it's got to be a Kestrel. I've had so many more nominations.
No.
But look at all these emails. Look, I will forward you the emails.
You barely won anything.
What are you doing? Socially distanced house meeting?
To pick our lockdown legend?
Duh.
Right. Why don't you just pick a legend a house?
Oh, so we can have one each. Okay, well, that makes sense. Well, in that case, it's easy. My Kestrel lockdown legend has been nominated by loads and loads of members of the staff. She always hands her work in on time. It's always to a really high standard. She's absolutely nailing lockdown. And it's Caitlin from 10ALD. Well done, Caitlin. You are a lockdown legend.
My lockdown legend has also been nominated by several members of staff, and Miss Lowing even referred to him as a legend and a machine. He's done every house competition and he's also been a fantastic house captain this year. So well done, Jack, from 10CAB. You are my lockdown legend.
My lockdown legend is Pola from 8HMH. She has a brilliant work ethic and has been nominated by many teachers because she always goes above and beyond. So well done, Pola!
Yeah, well done to all of our lockdown legends. Good work, guys, nailing it.
Llewellyn?
Mjolnir, Hammer of Thor. It's fallen from the sky and destroyed this area of the school. Can't pick it up though, because you're not worthy.
I'm pretty sure I can pick it up. Most powerful man in Harrow Way, not going to be a problem.
I think it's like wedged in or something. I think it's like, yeah. It's like stuck on the rock. And hang on a second. Let me get a better grip position. We'll have to get some people in. We'll see if we can get like a jackhammer or something. Well done.
Are you ready for another house challenge? House leaders!
Yes!
You will notice you have a piece of cardboard on the table in front of you. You have 2 minutes to make the best picture out of your cardboard. The best picture or model out of your cardboard. 2 minutes starts now. Not a very exciting start. Some very different approaches in play. I'm excited, I don't know about you. I mean, if you're not excited, get a cup of coffee. Thank you. 2 minutes suddenly seems like quite a long amount of time. I wish I'd told you to go make a cup of tea or something now. I mean, you haven't got time now. There's 30 seconds left. Fowler is confident.
I'm very confident.
Everyone, counting along at home. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up. Stop your model or picture making. Okay, let's have a little look at what everyone has done. What is this?
A sunshine day, the birds flying, and a sunflower growing.
Way to go, Hawks. Miss Fowler has made herself a lovely fan.
It's a fan because I am Buzzard's biggest fan.
It's even got a pun attached to it.
Okay, so it was meant to be a smiley face. Then it turned into a kind of nightmare creature, so it's a warning against not wearing face coverings, because...
Oh, at the last minute, I was very, very tempted to give that to Buzzards for speed, as much as anything, speed and finesse. Hawks, not even placed here. But at the last minute, I'm afraid, that is a Kestrel win for the second challenge. Well done, Kestrels. Well, it's not official. I mean, it can't be, because no one's actually competed in any sports on the field. But unofficially, no need for any more challenges. That's two challenges out of two. What about Fowler, back from the House Cup! Get back from the House Cup! Move back! You have not won any cups yet. But not to say that she's going to, because it could be anyone's cup. But the winner, once again, of the Sports Day trophy, even if it's unofficially, please, Mr. Manson, collect your trophy.
So, congratulations, Mr. Manson and the Kestrels.
Thank you, sir.
Well done, Kestrels.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the big moment. It's time to start giving away some of these other cups, officially this time. So first up, it's going to be the Attendance Cup and Attendance Awards in general. So let's hand over to Mrs. Woods.
Hello, everybody. Mrs. Woods here. So what we're going to do now is we're going to have the Attendance Award. So, as everybody knows, we haven't been in school for the past 3 months. So what we are doing is we are taking the attendance from September up to February half term. Now, we aim in Harrow Way, 96% is our minimum for attendance. But there are some students who have gone above and beyond and showed outstanding commitment and had 100% attendance. So let's take a look at who all those students. So if your name is here, well done to you all. So for those students that have achieved 100% attendance, 3 have been chosen at random and will get a £20 Amazon voucher posted to them. So let's see who the winners are. First one is Abigail Rapson of 7JBU. Next winner is Sean Charlotte of 8JPM. And the last one is Casey Southgate of 9RCL. So well done to you three. Next award then is going to the winning tutor group from each year group. So this is the tutor group that has the accumulation of the highest attendance. So let's have a look at year 7. The winner is 7JBU. For year 8, it is 8KJS. For year 9, it's 9KLE. And for year 10, It's 10 ECM. So well done to those tutor groups. You will find a big box of chocolates waiting for you to be shared together in September. So well done to you. Now the last award then goes for the Attendance House Cup. So let's see who's in third place. It's Kestrels with 95.08%. Second place, it's Buzzards, 95.09%, so close, but the winners are Hawks with 95.52%. Well done, everybody. Bye from me.
So congratulations, Miss Hamilton and Hawks, for the second year running the Attendance Trophy. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the moment you've all been waiting for. It's the announcement now of the final house point totals and the house cup. House leaders, are you excited?
Yeah!
Okay, here we go. We've got Mr. Serridge with us, ready to give that grand prize. So first off, the totals for year seven stamps. So, Ash, please. In first place, Hawks. Second place, Hawks. Third place, Hawks. Hawks have smashed the year seven house point totals. Let's have a look at the year eight stamper totals that add up to our house point. So, in first place, Kestrels. Second place, Hawks. Third place, Buzzards. Year eight produce an across the board score. Let's move on then to year nine. Year nine stamper totals, here we go. Buzzard. Buzzard. Kestrel. Oh, it's all very close. Remember, this all adds up, this all goes forward to that final total. Let's have a look at the year 10 stamper totals. Here we go. Kestrel. Hawk! Hawk! Okay. And for the first time ever, we are including year 11 in this. So year 11 have a chance to win a prize here as well. Here we go. 1 year only, a year 11 special. And year 11, if we haven't said it too many times today, if you are with us today, thank you so much for being with us today. And we do miss you. We do miss you. And be careful out there. Stay safe. Here we go then. It's a hawk! And a Kestrel! And a Kestrel! Oh yes, it's all very impressive. So all of those go into the pot. So the top student in each house for stamps across all year groups. Here we go. Buzzards on 1,336 stamps. Buzzard! Hawks on 1,268 stamps, so it was Demetrius for the Buzzards, it's Ruby for Hawks. And Kestrels on 1,191 stamps, what an amazing score, it is Kira. Okay, so overall then, all stamper totals added up. In third place, Miss Fowler, it's the Buzzards. In second place, it's the Hawks. But your house point stamp total winners this year is the Kestrels. But it's not over yet. Plenty of points to be played for. Let's move along. So here come the final calculations, everyone. So let's show you how we calculate that. So remember, every single time you get a stamp, every time you're in school, every time you're doing what you're supposed to be doing and you're ready for a lesson, that's the biggest thing here that contributes towards these final totals. That is one house point for every single stamp you receive, plus house points for taking part and winning events. Well, house points for winning events adds up, plus house points for taking part in events. So all of those things add up, and we've already gone through, the house leaders have already gone through all the amazing events that have happened in this year. In lockdown, but also, of course, before lockdown, back when school was normal. But wonderful taking part in events that have happened since lockdown has happened as well. And again, thank you to the house leaders and everyone else involved in getting those events going for us while we've not been here. So, let's have a look at all those events whizzing past. They're going to go well. So here come the house events. They're whizzing over through the screen. They're some of the various events that have added up to the points total. And this, we're not making the same mistake as last year. This isn't the winner of the House Cup, so calm yourself, Fowler. This is the winner of taking part in house events. So, here we go. It's third place, Hawks. Second place, Kestrels. And Fowler, now you can go crazy. For house events, it's the Buzzards. Some of you will have already started doing the maths on how that's going to look. So we're putting that all into the great big computer that we call Ash. Adding it all up, and now here come the big final announcements. This is this year, no mistakes. This is for the House Cup. Ready? Third place. It's the Hawks with 373,336 house points. Well done, Hawks. In second place, it's the Kestrels with 392,315 points, and they've sort of been running away with it through a lot of the year. However hard the other two houses have tried to make it a fight. Nonetheless, in first place, no surprise I think to anyone, with 412,193 points, it's the Buzzards! A great round of applause at home for everyone.
So congratulations, Miss Fowler and Buzzards.
Well, there it is, ladies and gentlemen, the 2020 end of year assembly. Thank you so much for coming. We look forward to seeing you in September. Have a wonderful...
Can we please, please do a final song?
All right. Just one more song.